Hello and welcome to Sports Fix on Friday the 10th of June.
Harry, thank you so much for inviting us into your house to do the interview today.
Hello and welcome to ISTV Sport, where today I'm joined by ex-Arsenal and Scotland goalkeeper Bob Wilson. Bob, thanks for your time today.
Which side am I coming?
That side.
That side.
Okay. And you're going to put your left foot in the stirrup there.
Don't film this bit, then.
Okay, yeah, definitely film that bit. Okay, and then shove your right leg round. That's it.
Hello and welcome to Branksome Beach. We're here for the Sandbanks Beach Polo Media Launch Party, and amongst all the glitz and the glamour, there's a serious sports side. Now, it's not every day you get to have a go at beach polo, but the guys have been kind enough to let me up on the horse, so here we go. Sorry. You okay? Sorry. I think I should get off now.
Hey Graham, thanks for joining us.
Pleasure.
Here today at the Rose Bowl, not for cricket though, playing darts later on. Slightly different warm-up.
Yeah.
Usual game of cricket.
I know, I'm rubbish at darts as well.
Paul have been lucky enough to bag themselves another home tie in the FA Vase. That now means they've been drawn at home in every round of the competition so far. Adding to that, this time they've been drawn against ranked underdogs Torpoint Athletic. But as Paul proved in the last round when they knocked out favourite Spennymoor Town, rankings mean absolutely nothing in this competition.
Starting with your own playing career, if you could pick a couple of words to describe it, what would you say? Did you achieve everything you wanted
from playing? No, not really.
What are your thoughts when you think back on this game? It's come from being played just in a pub in front of a few amount of people.
When it first started.
A crowd of thousands.
Yeah. Away from the football and Paul Town supporters and the fans of many clubs who have travelled to Tattenham throughout the season have helped raise over £1,100 for the Wessex Cancer Trust. Now, Paul have had to work really hard to get this far in the competition. In the last three rounds, they've had to come from behind to secure wins. It's been a real team effort, but one man in particular has stood out, striker Steve Smith, who scored 5 goals in 4 FA Vase appearances so far this season.
I couldn't come here today and not talk to you about football. You've got a double win with Arsenal.
Yeah.
How do you compare that with the achievement of your bike ride?
Oh, the double achievement was extraordinary.
First, we're off to the Rose Bowl though, where next Thursday will mark a momentous occasion in the ground's history as it hosts its first ever test match. England will take on Sri Lanka in the final game of their three test series, with the score currently at 1-0 to England. Ahead of the game, ISTV caught up with Hampshire chairman Rob Bransgrove, who is hopeful that next week's test will be the first of many, and that the Rose Bowl will one day be hosting Ashes test matches.
What about the rest of the fellas in the England team? They like a good kingfisher, or some of them white wine spritzers? I think you could tell a man from their drink.
I think you can. I mean, obviously we've got a couple of Pimms and Lemonade boys.
Can you name names?
Yeah, Strauss and Cook. But, you know, when you take the public school lads away, there's some good lads who enjoy curring a bit.
Just before we go, obviously we mentioned the international break. Your name is constantly being touted with the England manager's job. You said it's something you've always wanted to do, I believe.
Well, when things are going so well at Tottenham,
it's difficult, I imagine.
What I always said was that, you know, it was a job that an Englishman would find hard to turn down.
But the fact that is George's signature, original signature, makes it very special.
How good was he, Paul?
Whenever get asked on that, you can run through, obviously you can go through Pelé, Maradona, Cruyff, in the modern game, Lionel Messi.
Brilliant. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Harry, and best of luck at the end of the season in the Champions League.
You're very good at your job as well. That top class, I mean that.
Thank you very much. You
could do very well. You find it easy, don't you? It's great.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much for your time. Best of luck for the rest of the season. Cheers, Phil. Thank you.
Good brothers.
As always, thank you for watching. Have a brilliant weekend, and I'll see you next Friday.